Hello everyone, a very warm welcome in the session of Roj Project. I am Dongre AG from SGM College Karad. Today we are going to start here new chapter of 12th biology, that is respiration and circulation. Respiration and circulation, this topic is covering 7 to 10 marks. 7 marks ask question without option and 10 marks ask question with option. So let's move ahead. In old syllabus of 11th standard biology, respiration and circulation, both the topics we studied in separately. But in new syllabus of 12th standard, respiration and circulation, both the parts are combined together. Why both the topics are combined together? Because both the topics are related to the thoracic cavity. So this thoracic cavity here, in this thoracic cavity, here is a lungs, a pair of lungs, and heart is present. Both these organs help for the respiration and circulation process takes place. So, in generally, human body is made from three major cavities. First one is, or the upper one is thoracic cavity, middle one is abdominal cavity, and the last, that is lower one, is pelvic cavity. So before going to start today's topic, we understand here which sub points are given in this topic. So first one is respiration. So related to the respiration, which subtopics are given in your textbook? So the first one is definition of respiration, organs of respiratory exchange, gases exchange in plants, respiration in animals, human respiratory system, mechanism of respiration, regulation of breathing. So how can be breathing regulates modified respiratory movement, common disorder of respiratory system, artificial ventilation, ventilators, and last part is transportation in living organism. This all sub points related to the respiration. Now next, circulation. So in circulation, there is a circulation in animals, blood vascular system and its types, circulatory system in humans, red blood corpuscles is also known as erythrocytes, that is RBCs, white blood corpuscles is also known as leukocytes, that is WBCs, then thrombocytes or platelets. And the main important part in this part, that is human heart, then working mechanism of human heart, blood vessels, blood pressures, that is BP, electrocardiogram, lymphatic system. These are the sub points of circulation. So these are the different sub points related to our today's topic. So again, before going to today's topic or today's lecture, we need to understand here which life processes are done all living organisms. So all living organisms require energy to carry out various life processes. So again, here is life processes perform with the help of energy. So which type of life processes are performed all living organisms? So see here, first one is nutrition, this is the life process. Then next one is respiration, third one is transportation, fourth one is excretion, control, growth, reproduction, and movement. These are the life processes. So these life processes are require energy. Without energy we cannot done these processes. So that's why life processes, when we perform, there is a required energy or the necessary of energy. So we see here how or where we come from energy. Tar ti energy aplyala kuthun milte? So we see here in this video how come from energy. So from this video, we more understand where come from energy.
To perform any activity of life processes, we need energy. This energy we obtain from the breakdown of organic molecules such as carbohydrate, fats and proteins inside the bodies to the cells. During the process breaking down the organic molecules, the cells continuously use oxygen and release carbon dioxide. To provide fresh oxygen to the cells and to remove carbon dioxide, which
here is a, when we inhale oxygen, at that time this particular oxygen goes inside inner lungs and there is a so many respiratory processes performed. After respiration or when we intake of oxygen, then this particular oxygen is combined in blood and remove the carbon dioxide. See here
again, which is harmful to the living organism. Inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. This process of inhaling and exhaling is known as breathing. The process of breathing accompanied by the breakdown of food to produce energy is known as respiration.
So this particular respiration process, after completing respiration process, we get energy. So this particular cell, in this particular cell, here is a respiration process will be completed. Then after completed respiration process, we get energy. So in this video, we see, then now come to today's lecture, that is particular part, respiration. So here is a, first of all, one question is what exactly the meaning of respiration or the definition of respiration. So it is a biochemical process of oxidation. So respiration is also known as biochemical process. So what is the meaning of biochemical? Bio means living and chemical means chemical reaction. So this chemical reaction performed in the living organism, that particular process is known as biochemical process. This biochemical process of oxidation of organic compounds. So organic compound means carbohydrate, proteins, fats. This type of food molecules is known as organic compound. So when we intake of food molecules, these food molecules combine with oxygen and there is a oxidation process is completed. Then after completing oxidation process, our body liberate a chemical energy in the form of ATP. So we get a chemical energy and this energy we get or stored in the form of ATP. ATP means adenosine triphosphate. This is the unit of energy. So this particular respiration process we express in the form of chemical reaction. So see here, chemical reaction, when we intake of C6H12O6, that is a particular carbohydrate food material. This carbohydrate food material oxidize with the help of oxygen. Then after oxidation we get 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water. So this is not exactly water, but this is a water vapor. Then next important product we get, that is energy. So this energy we form or we stored in the form of ATP. ATP means adenosine triphosphate. So this particular ATP we get 100%, but out of 100% only 40% energy we stored in the body. Remaining 60% energy we release in the form of heat. So this is a particular chemical reaction. This chemical reaction express the respiration process. Both the topics or both the parts are very very important. So definition of respiration and its chemical reaction. Then now see again here one picture. So in this picture, when we see in this picture, when we inhale oxygen, at that time this oxygen mixed in the blood and remove carbon dioxide. So with the help of blood, oxygen reach each and every cells. So this particular respiration process takes place between the living organism and atmosphere. So respiration process is also known as gaseous exchange process or exchange of gases. So exchange of gases process takes place between the living organism and atmosphere. So particular this gaseous exchange process takes place with the help of particular respiratory site. So respiratory site means respiratory surface. So which type of respiratory surfaces are found in all living organism? So again here is, as you all of you knows that in our earth surface different type of living organisms are exist. So these different living organisms exist or has a different respiratory surfaces. So different respiratory surfaces means respiratory part in living organisms. Different living organisms has a different respiratory surfaces. So this respiratory surfaces must be a respiratory surface for efficient exchange gases. So this efficient gases exchange, the respiratory surface should have the following features. So some features must for the efficient gases exchange takes place. So first feature is it should have a large surface area. So large surface area, more gases exchange takes place. It should be thin surface area, or the plasma membrane should be thin. So thin plasma membrane, there is a more gases exchange takes place. Highly vascular blood capillaries, there is a more, there is more gases exchange process and permeable to allow exchange of gases. Then next one is it should be moist. So surface or the respiratory surface should be moist. Why respiratory surface is moist? Because gases exchange process will be takes place in oxygen and carbon dioxide. So oxygen and carbon dioxide is dissolved in the moist place. So both the gases are dissolved at particular surface, that surface is moist, or that surface should be moist. So these are the three different respiratory surfaces, and these three respiratory surfaces or features are very very important. Then again come to the next point in this lecture, gases exchange in plants. So respiration process or gases exchange process takes place in living organism, that is plants as well as animals. So different plants and animals are exist in our earth surface. That's why different living organism has a different respiratory surface. So in plants, so a terrestrial flowering plants has many air spaces. We take one example of terrestrial flowering plants. These terrestrial flowering plants has a many air spaces between the cells. Between the cells there is a many air spaces are present. With the help of air spaces, terrestrial flowering plants takes place gaseous exchange process. So between the cells of leaf, stem and roots, these are the respiratory parts. So in these respiratory parts there is a gaseous exchange process takes place. In leaf and young stem, so respire through stomata. In leaf, respire or respiration process performed through the stomata. So stomata is present on the lower and upper surface of leaves. So there is a small pores is present. So with the help of small pores, leaves perform its respiration process and water vapors also diffuse out. The next one is that is root. So in aerated soil, root are present in aerated soil. So there is a oxygen dissolve in the film of moisture. So with the help of dissolved oxygen, roots getting a oxygen and its respiration process takes place there. Or water around the root tissue and enter by diffusion process. So again plants perform its gaseous exchange process by the diffusion process. So what is the meaning of diffusion process? Diffusion process means the movement of particular gases from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration till equilibrium reach. Then next part is that is stem. Woody flowering plants, that is trees and shrubs. So trees and shrubs have an external impervious bark and lenticels. So see here, this is a woody flowering plant. Trees plant, then on the upper surface of trees, there is an external impervious bark present. And in this impervious bark, there is a small pores are present. With the help of small pores, or this small pores is known as lenticels. So with the help of lenticels, woody flowering plants perform its gaseous exchange process. So in plant, there is a stomata is present. Then again is woody flowering plant, there is an impervious bark and lenticels are present. With the help of lenticels and stomata, plants perform its gaseous exchange process. So this is a stomata, stomatal pores. When stomatal pores are opening, there is a respiration process takes place. Then now see one video. In this video, how plants perform its gaseous exchange process. See here.
Plants have no specialized organs for respiration. This is because plants utilize less oxygen for the oxidation of food. Plants utilize only a small amount of food for oxidation.
So plants utilize less food used for oxidation. Plants हे काय करतात less amount मध्ये जो food आहे तो use करतात कशासाठी oxidation process perform करण्यासाठी.
And have the rest of the use building their body in the form of cellulose. Further, the demand of oxygen is supplied during photosynthesis when oxygen is end product. Plants respire through small openings called stomata, which is present on the lower and upper surface of the leaves, and lenticels on stem as well as roots. So see the picture, stem, roots and leaves.
So this particular picture, we understand here how plants respire and which particular organs or respiratory surfaces are helped. Then now next part is respiration in animals. Then again here is a different animals present in our earth surface. That's why different animals has a different respiratory surface depending upon their habitat and complexity of organisms. So again here is respiratory surface for gases exchange must be thin, highly vascular and permeable for gases exchange. Then various kinds of respiratory surfaces or organs in the animals are. So see here, different animals has a different respiratory surfaces depending upon their habitat. So see here, first particular living organism are the animals. We take one example, various kinds of respiratory surfaces or organs in animals are. So protists like sponges and cnidarians like hydra and jellyfish. So these animals live in water. So live in water means its habitat is aquatic and its respiratory surface is plasma membrane and general body surface. So example we see here, first one is that is sponges. So this is sponge This is the diagram of sponge. On the upper surface of sponge, there is a small pores are present. With the help of small pores, sponge perform its respiration process or gases exchange process. So, this general body surface, there is a general body surface. Then next example, there is a jellyfish. So, on the upper surface of jellyfish, plasma membrane is present. With the help of plasma membrane, jellyfish perform its respiration process. Then again one picture, see here, sponge. This is a sponge on the upper surface of porous. This is a porous like structure. With the help of these pores, sponge perform its respiration process. Now we will see next example of animals. Flatworm like planaria and annelids like earthworm and leech. These are the example of animals. Its habitat is aquatic or semi-aquatic. Aquatic as well as semi-aquatic. Some animals live in water and some animals live in sometimes water and sometimes on land. Its respiratory surface is plasma membrane, general body surface or moist skin. So, see one example. Here is planaria. So, planaria perform its respiration process. Then, next one is earthworm. So, on the upper surface of earthworm, there is a moist skin. With the help of this moist skin, earthworm perform its respiration process. Then, see nereis. And again, here is leech. And this is earthworm. This is a scientific name of earthworm. Then now next one is arthropoda, that is insects like cockroach, butterfly. Its habitat is terrestrial and the respiratory surface is tracheal tube and spiracles. So see the example of insect. So on the upper surface of insect, there is a small tubes are present. This small tube is known as trachea. So one thing we understand here, insects has no circulatory fluid. So this particular animal perform its respiration process with the help of tracheal tubes. So this tracheal tubes opens a small pore. This small pore is known as spiracles. So with the help of spiracles, these animals perform its respiration process. Now again we will see next example of animals, that is arachnids like spider and scorpions. Its habitat terrestrial. Then its respiratory surface is book lungs. So see example of scorpion. This is a scorpion. On the upper surface of scorpion, there is a look like or arrangement of pages of book. So that's, it is known as book lungs. So with the help of book lungs, scorpions perform its respiration process. Now next example, this is a spider. So on the upper surface of spider, there is a book lungs are present. So with the help of book lungs, spider perform its respiration process. Then we will see again, here is some examples. Arthropoda like limulus, its habitat is aquatic, respiratory surface is book gills. So see here example of limulus. On the upper surface of king crab or limulus, there is a arrangement of book like structure. This book like structure is known as book gills. So with the help of book gills, limulus perform its respiration process. Now see again, here is next example of amphibian, tadpoles of frog, salamander and nets. So its living structure is aquatic, or the habitat is aquatic. Respiratory surface is external gills and moist skin. So tadpole of frog has a moist skin. So on the upper surface, here is a moist skin is present. With the help of moist skin, frog perform its respiration process. Now see again, here is a next example of this type of animals. This is salamander and frog. On the upper surface of, here is external gills are present. With the help of gills, salamander perform its respiration process. Then now come to the next example of animal, that is fishes. Like Katla, seahorse, its habitat is aquatic. These animals always live in water. So that's why its respiratory surface is internal gills. See the example. This is seahorse and this is a example of fish. So here is a fish, absorb water means oxygen. So this oxygen go inside in the body and these fishes perform its respiration process with the help of gills. The next example of well developed organs of animals, that is reptiles, birds and mammals. Its habitat terrestrial and respiratory surfaces, lungs. Lungs is well developed. So see the example. With the help of lungs, these all animals perform its respiration process. So see again, here is a examples of, this is a reptiles, these are animals are birds and these are the mammals. So all are well developed living organisms. So that's why all has a well developed respiratory surface, that is the lungs. Then now last example of animals, that is turtle. Its habitat is under in water, then respiratory surface is cloaca. See the example of animal, that is a cloaca. So with the help of cloaca, turtles perform its respiration process. So these all animals we see here, how can be perform its respiration process. So again we more understand with the help of this video. So see the or watch this particular video, how can be all different type of animals perform its respiration process. So see this video.
The mechanism of breathing depending upon habitat and level of organization of an animal. Lower invertebrates such as sponges, cnidarians and flatworms.
So this is the sponges and these are the cnidarians and flatworms. So on the upper surface of there is a small pores are present. With the help of these small pores, this type of animals perform its respiration process.
Exchange gases by the simple diffusion to their body surface. In insects such as cockroaches and earthworms has a tubular extensions of the body wall called trachea, and moist skin help transport atmospheric air throughout the body. Then most mollusks use special vascularized structure called tenidium for gases exchange. See the picture. And some arthropods like spiders and scorpions use many skin sole membranes presenting the pages of books to respiration. There are called book lungs. So see the picture. Terrestrial forms of vertebrates use bacillarized bags called lungs. Among vertebrates, fishes respire through gills, whereas amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals respire through lungs. Apart from lungs, frogs can also respire through moist skin.
So on the upper surface of frog, here is a moist skin is present. So in the on the upper surface of moist skin, this particular frog perform its respiration process. So intake of oxygen and release the carbon dioxide. This is the gaseous exchange process or respiration process. So now next table is organism. Different type of organisms are given, different habitat also given, and its different respiratory organs are given in this table. This table already given in your textbook. So see this table. Then this Particular table shows the different living organism has different respiratory surface. So here is today's lecture is completed. So thank you.